Hello dear students, how are you all? Welcome back. As you all know that we are doing chapter number 2 of class 11th chemistry subject, that is structure of atom. And in continuity of this chapter, today we are going to discuss about our next topic, that is de Broglie's wave concept. De Broglie's wave concept. Actually, the analogy between the matter and radiant energy was developed by Planck and Einstein in earlier 19th. And it was further extended by a French physicist known as Louis de Broglie in 1924. He suggested that like photons, every material particle, like electrons, protons, neutrons, atoms, molecules, not only atom molecules but also a stone, a cricket ball, when they are in motion, they possess the dual character. And what this dual character is? Dual character means they behave as a wave as well as they show the particle nature. It means every microscopic particle as well as macroscopic particles, when they are in motion, they are associated with the wave nature, and the wavelength of every particle wave can be expressed by the given equation, and this equation is equal to lambda is equal to h upon mv. Lambda is equal to h upon mv, where lambda is, we all know that lambda is wavelength, and what is h here? H is Planck's constant, and the value of Planck's constant is 6.63 into 10 raised to power minus 34 joule second. And what is m here? M will be the mass of that particle, and what will be the v here? V is velocity of that particle, velocity of the particle. Okay, so first of all, we will derive this equation. And how de Broglie derived this equation? Actually, he correlated the two characters in the form of an equation, and from where he derived this equation. So first of all, we will do the derivation of this equation. We know that according to Planck's quantum theory, E is equal to, means energy, is equal to h nu. First, we will derive this equation for a photon. We know that velocity of light is equal to lambda, product of lambda into nu, where nu is frequency of photon and lambda is wavelength of photon, and c is velocity of light or photon. So nu is equal to c upon lambda. So we get here E is equal to h c upon lambda. Let this equation be equal to 1. Okay, and according to Einstein, we all know that mass energy equivalence, it can be expressed as E is equal to mc square. Let this equation be equal to 2. Now from 1 and 2, we get h c upon lambda is equal to mc square. Can cancel this c with another c on the both side, so we will get from here, on rearranging, we will get lambda is equal to h upon mc. Lambda is equal to h upon mc. So this is the wavelength. So let this equation be equal to 3. Now de Broglie proposed that this equation is applicable to any particle or every particle which is in motion. Here the mass of photon that is m is replaced by a mass of particle, let it be m again, and the velocity of light that we have taken c is replaced by velocity of a particle, let it be v now. So from equation number 3 we have lambda is equal to h upon mc, and on substituting these values we will get h upon mv for every particle. Now we all know that m and v means product of mass and velocity is momentum of that particle. So we can also write this equation as lambda is equal to h upon p. So from here we conclude that lambda is directly proportional to 1 upon p. Lambda is equal to h upon p means lambda is inversely proportional to p. P means momentum of that particle. So from here we derive the equation, that is lambda is equal to h upon mv means h upon p. So this is our de Broglie's equation. And now from here, suppose the kinetic energy of a particle having mass m is equal to k, and we all know that kinetic energy of particle here, suppose a particle is moving at the velocity v, so the kinetic energy of the particle will be equal to 1 by 2 mv square. Now on rearranging this equation we will get mv square is equal to 2k. This 2 will be gone on the left hand side, so we get mv square is equal to 2k. Remember this k is kinetic energy of a particle. Now multiply on both sides by m, multiply by m on the both sides, we get 2k into m means 2mk. Let's rearrange it, 2mk. Now from here we get m square v square, which we can write as mv whole square, that is equal to 2mk. Again take this 2 on the right side, this will convert into square root, so we get mv is equal to square root of 2mk. Now put this value in this equation, we get lambda is equal to h upon 2mk square root. This is another form of de Broglie's equation in terms of kinetic energy. Actually this equation is very useful in solving the numericals. So remember both these equations, this equation will be helpful for solving the numericals. Now further, German and Davison made the following modification in the de Broglie's equation. What these modifications are? Let a charged particle, say an electron, be accelerated with a potential, say V, then the kinetic energy of particle may be given as, kinetic energy formula of kinetic energy is half mv square, and it will be equal to q into v, where q is the charge on that particle and v is the potential. Okay, here q is charge on that particle. Charge on particle. Particle is electron. So from here we get mv square is equal to 2qv. Again multiplying on both sides by m, we get 2qv into m, means mv whole square is equal to 2qmv. So we have lambda is equal to h upon mv. And what we get here? Here we get mv is equal to 2qmv square root. So we will put this equation here, 2qmv square root. This is the another equation which was modified by the Germerer Davison. Okay, and for electron, we all know that for electron, the charge on electron is always 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb, and the mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. H Planck's constant is equal to 6.63, or we can take 6.26 into 10 raised to power minus 34 joule second. On putting this all values in this equation, we will get the result, and this result will be equal to 12.27 divided by square root V in angstrom units. So you have to remember this result. This result is very much important for the competitive exams, so kindly remember this. So on the basis of de Broglie's equation, the following conclusion can be drawn, that the lighter is the particle, greater will be its de Broglie wavelength for a certain velocity. Like we know that lambda is equal to h upon mv. So from here we conclude that lambda is inversely proportional to v. Greater the value of v, lesser will be the value of lambda. Similarly, faster the particle move, smaller will be its de Broglie wavelength. And remember one thing, de Broglie wavelength is independent of the nature of a particle. It is independent on nature of a particle. And our next topic is the significance of de Broglie's equation in our daily life. Actually, the wavelength of macroscopic bodies like cricket ball and stone, they are very small as their masses are very large. Hence, it can be ignored, but for microscopic particles like electrons, the wavelength are considerable. Hence, we can say that it has no significance in our daily life. It can be understood by taking the example. Suppose we have an electron and a cricket ball. Let the mass of the ball is 200 gram. Convert this into kg, it will be 0.2 kg. And the for electron, we know that the mass of electron is 9.11 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. Okay, suppose both these particles move with the same velocity, and this velocity is equal to 10 raised to power 6 meter per second. 10 raised to power 6 meter per second. Now calculate the wavelength for the both. For electron, this we know that lambda is equal to h upon mv. On putting all these values, the 6.626 into 10 raised to power 34 divided by the mass of electron is 9.11 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg, and velocity we have taken here 10 raised to power 6 meter per second. On calculating these values, the value of lambda comes out to be 7.28 into 10 raised to power minus 10 meter. Similarly, find out the value of lambda for the cricket ball, which is moving with the same velocity, but the mass of this cricket ball is taken 0.2 kg. So here lambda is equal to h upon mv again, and the value of h is 6.6 6.26 into 10 raised to power minus 34 divided by mass. Mass is taken here 0.2 kg and velocity is 10 raised to power 6. And on calculating these values, we will get the result. The lambda will be equal to 3.313 into 10 raised to power minus 39. Minus 39 meter. So on comparing these values, here the wavelength for the ball is very, very small. Very small. It can be neglected. So we can conclude from here, the de Broglie wave equation or wave concept has no significance in our daily life. No significance in our daily life. Okay. So this is all about de Broglie's wave equation. Thank you. Thank you so much.